Part of their memories live right here.
Sense of belonging, sense of caring for each other, sense of community.
Local contractor Jake Plagenkuhl was broken after knowing the tragedies that devastated thousands at the Route 91 country music concert last Sunday. He wanted to do something for those hurting, as well as the innocent who no longer had a physical footprint.
Monday morning, it was really hard to get going, you know, after what had happened Sunday night. And I own a small landscape company, a design build company. And my partner in the company and I were having a cup of coffee that morning trying to figure out what we were going to do and how do we even approach the day and move forward. And we thought, you know, it's a shame that we don't have a healing garden.
And it was this drawing right here that helped transform this quarter acre of land into a healing garden. Plagenkuhl and his business partner called their city hall contact. Among the three of them, their feelings of sadness for those lost and love for humanity brought about the idea of building the Las Vegas Healing Memorial Gardens.
One of my favorite quotes is, "He who plants a tree plants hope."
58 trees are being planted, one for each victim lost on Sunday. Thinking only a dozen people would show up, hundreds of volunteers came to offer the labor of love with their hearts and their own hands. All supplies, including equipment, were all donated.
Very humbly.
For Nell Stannard, the idea of helping to build a memorial touched her.
I've had people that close to me that have been affected by this. A friend of mine, her mom got shrapnel in her shoulder, and it's horrible, and I'm just so happy that we're coming together as an entire team.
So to her, this is a way for their memory to still live on.
You know, friends of friends who have passed, you know, same social circle, but never really got to know them, and now I can never do that.
And for Sarah O'Connell, this was her opportunity to give back.
I'm a theater artist, and so making spaces to come together is what I'm all about. For once, it's something that won't be over when the show's over. It'll be here a long time.
The shooting near the stage hit a little too close to home for her.
Besides just the shock of the violence, it hits home for me because we have a lighting business. I'm a theater director, and the lighting people, the lighting designer and operator is usually on a platform in the middle of the audience, and normally that'd be my husband.
In addition to the 58 trees being planted, one large oak tree donated by Siegfried and Roy is the park's tree of life.
After what happened on Sunday night, we wanted to remember those people who lost their lives. So that's why we decided 58 trees, but yet we wanted something really positive and strong yet, so we planted this oak tree.
Plagenkuhl says once they began to dig in that spot, they discovered a Tree of Life necklace.
The woman that I just met here who lost her son in this, and we just thought it was really important that the family have that Tree of Life necklace.